With the default deadline just a week away, 11 News went to Washington to hear what the leaders you sent to Capitol Hill have to say about this stalemate. 11 News reporter Kai Reed is live tonight on Federal Hill with that part of the story. Kai?
Well, Marianne, you know, a lot of Americans are really fed up with this process. Maryland lawmakers say they are as well. They all talk about the need for compromise. That word comes up over and over again. But tonight, Congress and the White House are still no closer to a deal.
Dozens rallied outside of Congressman Roscoe Bartlett's office in Frederick. Thousands of others lit up the phones on Capitol Hill. They're calling for an end to the debt ceiling debate, some kind of compromise. Maryland lawmakers acknowledge ordinary Americans are frustrated and angry.
I'm prepared to compromise. I think the majority of the members of Congress are prepared to compromise. I think Speaker Boehnert needs to bring in the extreme elements of the Republican Party in the House and say, look, it's time to compromise.
We ought to be able to reach agreement here. I think, unfortunately, there is a group within the House of Representatives, in the Republican majority, that has decided that they're just going to draw the line. They don't want to make reasonable compromise.
Voicing his frustration with the president, freshman Republican Congressman Andy Harris insists a balanced budget amendment is an essential part of the process.
I do think a lot of the freshmen do think that a balanced budget amendment is an important part of this mix. And again, I think we are disappointed that the president rejects it out of hand.
The Republicans have their proposal, but I don't think that proposal, Boehner's proposal, would be able to even get out of the House. A lot of very conservative and Tea Partiers are saying they don't like that one. And this is everything that Boehner has been asking for.
We, the Democrats, have given. We've showed that we're willing to make cuts. We've already voted on three separate cuts packages. We're willing to make changes. But we need, you cannot compromise with only yourself.
According to a Reuters Ipsos poll released after the president's speech, 56% of Americans say the solution is a mix of spending cuts and tax increases. With just 1 week to go before the deadline, time is running out.
Right now, it's getting to the point where it's affecting our country, our stability. I don't want our country to be second to anybody, and neither to any other Americans. And if we don't resolve this issue and stop the politics, we're going to have serious problems.
And now a vote on the House plan was scheduled for tomorrow, but that has now been postponed until Thursday due to questions over the speaker's proposed budget savings. Reporting live in Federal Hill, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.